Hello, my dear students. This is Sonia Kaushik, and today I'm going to show you some interesting structures. Yes, you recognize these structures. These are cones that are present in gymnosperm that have date seed, non-flowering plants. See, this is male cone, smaller one, and this is female cone, larger one. Actually, these are brown in color. This is colored by students actually. So, this larger one is female cone, and this smaller one is male cone. These woody structure, leaf-like structures, these are actually called microsporophyll in case of male cone and megasporophyll in case of female cone. And this megasporophyll helps in formation of megaspore that have megaspore mother cells, and it have microspore mother cell that helps in formation of microspore that are also called pollen grains. Alright, so what is the position of these male and female cone in plant? Let me show you that. See, this is a structure of a gymnosperm tree in which you can see upper one is female cone and lower one is male cone. This female cone grows on the upper branches where they can be easily fertilized by the help of pollen grains that are blown by wind, and that is called wind pollination. Wind pollen grains are there, and that helps in pollination by wind, that is called anemophily. And in the second structure, you can see male and female cone. In the lower side, you can see the megasporophyll is shown in the diagram, that is a form of scale leaf that have megaspore in the last. And when the pollen grains come to the lower side, it will start germinating and form pollen tube, and pollen tube carries two male nuclei, that is sperm you can say, or one is genitive nuclei, other is tube nucleus that fused with ovule, and fertilization occurs, and ultimately seeds formation occurs with the help of that are the products of this fertilization that are dispersed and grow into mature trees. Right, so male cones are present on the lower branches of a tree, and female cones are generally present on the higher branches or the upper branches of the tree. You can see again the structure of this female cone, and this is male cone, and if you see, these are megasporophylls and this is microsporophyll. You can see clearly. Yes, if we see the structure internally, you can see here. Yes, in the upper diagram you can see megaspore, microsporophyll, and in the lower structure you can see megasporophyll that are attached to a central bract like structures. In B part you can see the microspores that are formed inside the microsporophyll, and in the C diagram you can see winged pollen grain that can be easily dispersed with the help of wind, because in gymnosperm wind pollination is most common. And if you see the diagram of megasporophyll, and in the individual megasporophyll there is a ovule, or you can say megaspore at the base. Out of four megaspore, only one megaspore is functional. So this is functional megaspore that will be formed with the help of megaspore mother cell, and at the end of micropyle pollen grain will enter and it will germinate to form pollen tube. And you know pollen tube carrying two gametes that will fuse with that is called syngamy or fertilization, and then ultimately seed formation will occur. So this is all about male and female cone. In case of some gymnosperm, they may be present on same tree, and like in case of pinus, in upper branches female cone are there, lower branches male cones are there. And in case of cycas, different plants having different cones, like some plants having male cone and some plants having female cone. So I hope the concept of cones, male and female cones, is now clear to you. Alright, so this is all about gymnosperms, male and female cone. I hope you like this video. Goodbye.